And the next day, he came on board and got into the submersible, and it was like a completely different person. You could just see, which is very clear in the episode, you know, how afraid he was. He speaks very frankly about his fear of the ocean.
Hi, Diva.
Dana, lovely to meet you.
Nice to meet you too. Thank you so much for your time. It's a pleasure to talk to you. It's not every day that we talk with a marine biologist. Yes, no, it's not.
Well, I'm excited.
Yes, it's such a pleasure. Oh my God, I watched the episode that you're in, and I was like amazed with everything. Like, it's so much to learn. And I think you have a lot to give, you know what I mean, to teach everybody else. So let's start from the beginning, like how this invitation came on board, how everything started.
I mean, it's a funny story. I remember I got an email inviting me to be part of this incredible production, Welcome to Earth, and I didn't think it was real. I actually thought it was spam, and so I didn't respond. And it was only when they sent a follow-up email that I was like, oh, okay. And I think for the entire until the day I met Will in the Bahamas, it was like total disbelief almost, like it wasn't gonna happen. And yeah, then after that was it. It was just this wild ride together down into the depths of the Bahamas and experiencing all these, you know, new life forms and color in a way that Will had never experienced before.
And I bet you had a great time with him, like an amazing experience. How is to be like close to him? And I think he was really nervous, really scary to go down, right?
Yeah, bless him. So, I mean, I think this is the thing, right? I met him the day before, and he was this, like, exactly what you see on screen, this, like, lovely, witty, funny, charming guy. And we hit it, I mean, we hit it off, right? We both had really good senses of humor. It was great. And so I was like, oh, this is gonna be a piece of cake. And then the next day, he came on board and got into the submersible, and it was like a completely different person. You could just see, which is very clear in the episode, you know, how afraid he was. He speaks very frankly about his fear of the ocean. And this was not just the ocean, right? This is going to a part of the ocean that no one has been before. And going to a part of the ocean that if something goes wrong, no one is coming to help us. So it's his fear was totally understandable. And I think that fear, you know, seeing his fear really helped to humanize him. Like, it made me realize, hey, this isn't an A-list celebrity, right, sitting next to me. He's also a human being who has real life fears and anxieties just like the rest of us. And it was wonderful to watch him, you know, as the dive progressed, really overcome those fears, to see his resilience, to see that fear turn into awe, to, you know, inspiration, to amazement at all that we experience in the deep sea together. So it was just a really wonderful experience, and honestly, one of the easiest working days of my life, and I wish we'd had more of them together.
Oh my God, that's amazing. The whole like the episodes that I watch, everything's so real, and then I think that humanize him because
Exactly.
it's way different than we see him on screen. Of course, he does a lot of like these action movies, all this
Absolutely.
CGI crazy stuff, but now he's on the real world, you
Yeah.
know, in the real
Forced
earth.
to do exploration and adventure for real, right? And you can see that there is this process he goes through in every single episode about overcoming that fear. And so,
Yeah.
yeah, it's really wonderful to watch.
And like, for you as a marine biologist, what do you like the most about the deep sea, like down there?
Oh, I mean, that's a really hard question. I mean, I think something that I love about the deep ocean is just how incredible. I mean, it's always going to be about the life, right? About the life in the deep sea and about how varied it is. I mean, you have everything from glowing sharks to anemones with 8-foot-long tentacles to crabs that have hairy chests that they farm bacteria on that they can then eat. You know, really, there is just this like diversity of life in the deep sea that just blows your mind. And I'm so grateful that Welcome to Earth really takes people into the deep ocean because not a lot of people get to go there. And it really shines a light on this very unexplored but very important part of our planet.
Yeah, that's very interesting because people go more to the space than you also mentioned that on the episode, than to deep in the sea. And deep in the sea is right there, you know, it's right here. I don't know if it's easier. I don't know.
Something that I often say is like, you know, perhaps it's that it's like humans, right? You know, we love looking outward. We love looking at other things. And we very rarely look inward at ourselves because we often find problems, right? And or something that will challenge us. And I think perhaps it's the same, right? It's the same with space. You look outward and you see new and exciting things. And actually, if we were to look inward more, we're often faced with problems that we have created. So every time we go into the deep sea, we find our trash or we find, you know, the impacts of fishing. And those are often in places that no one has been before. So it's almost like, you know, you're forced to like deal with uncomfortable truths, if you will, kind of.
Yeah. Yeah. I know that you're very used to that, but are you not afraid when the submarine cracks, like the crack mode? I was freaking out. I was like, oh my God.
Definitely the first time I went down, which was like a while ago, I was very afraid. And that was actually to way deeper. That was like 2.5 kilometers. So more than double what I did with Will. But you know, with time, you just kind of get over these fears. It becomes part of the routine. It's funny because, you know, yes, you always have that fear in the back of your mind that, hey, if something goes wrong, there's nothing anyone can do, right? But I think the bigger fear, which is almost like a little silly, is like you're in there for like 9 hours at a time sometimes, and there's no bathroom. And so if you gotta go,
that's right,
you can go. And so for me, that is often the bigger fear in the forefront of my mind. Rather than, hey, no one's coming to rescue you.
Exactly. And for us, like to wrap it up, what is the importance for you to be like a woman and from Trinidad, and to be like, now everybody's gonna get to know you? You know what I mean? Because the series will be in Disney Plus. How is it important for you to be part of this project?
I mean, I think one of the things I love about this series is that it really redefines what we think about when we think about the word explorer. It's no longer, you know, a posh white man from a developed country. That is not what this series is at all. Between Eric, Christina, Albert, Dwayne, and I, we are changing what people will change what people think about when they think about the word explorer. And not only is it like really redefining what an explorer is, but it's also redefining why we explore. I think exploration, you know, at least in like colonial times, was often linked to like extraction or exploitation, if you will. And now through National Geographic, through Disney Plus, we're seeing exploration being done so that we can understand more about this planet. And we can then use that information we gather to be able to protect it better than we are currently.
Amazing. Diva, I just want to thank you so much for your time. A pleasure to talk to you. Nice to meet you. And
thank
a lot of success.
So
and keep going with your explorations. thank you so much.
Thank you, John. It's been wonderful. Thank you.
Bye-bye. If you like this video, don't forget to comment, to like, and subscribe to our channel right here.